Krimzon X, and welcome to my fucking documentary, motherfuckers. Gang, what's good? Welcome to Documentary of Krimzon X's Life, Part 1. The Krimzon X Documentary, Part 1 of 3. There's gonna be 3 parts to this documentary. This week, I'm giving you Part 1 of my documentary. Nobody can tell my story better than myself.
We got a hot chick, and we got Dave.
He's like, oh shit.
Oh, listen.
This is not a good combination. Cut Dave out.
No. This motherfucker, dude, when I was like 12 to 13, this motherfucker tried to burn me alive.
You know, I tried to burn him alive.
I carried a fucking gun. I didn't hesitate.
We went to Detroit carrying Glocks.
I will slap a bitch, fucking smoke a motherfucker, and not.
This documentary is about my hard hustles, my hard grinds, my hard fucking work that I put into this underground and I put into my music. People only know Krimzon by what they see on TV. They don't know the real Krimzon. They don't know the hustling, hardworking, dedicated motherfucker that they think they know. Of all the jealousy, all the envy, all the motherfuckers just wanting to be me, mad that they ain't me.
I've been in the game for like 10 years, you know? Man, I think we should do a diss track on that Krimzon guy. Maybe we can get some recognition. I mean, I don't understand. He was on the Dr. Phil show, and he's making the underground look bad, man. So, like, they don't give recognition to artists like me that been in the game for, like, fuck, I've been grinding for, like, 10 years. You know what I'm saying, man? And then maybe I can get an interview on the underground radio afterwards, man. Yeah, let's go do a diss track on that Krimzon motherfucker, man. Fuck that dude. I'm gonna kick that dude's ass, man. I'm telling you, Krimzon ain't got shit on me, motherfucker. But, man, Krimzon don't know the underground, man. He ain't a true hustler. You don't even know how to rap, man. Fuck this shit, man.
But you people know who you are, especially the ones that go as far as even making up rumors, sex pedophile, peed in front of kids. You know who you are. Fucking ain't nothing like that on my criminal record. And if anybody would like to look up Krimzon X's criminal record, why don't you take a look? Nicholas Joseph Gedry, inmate 443-348. And my entire record will be available for you free online. See, I don't gotta hide. I don't gotta fucking lie to fucking get people to like me. You know, in this game, I found out there was a lot of fake motherfuckers. I found out to trust nobody but myself, pretty much. And most of these motherfuckers that are hating on me now, fucking at one time brought me onto their little radio shows and shit. And the funny thing is, you can take a look at all their videos. 40, 50, 60 views tops. You look at the Krimzon X video, 8, 9, 10,000 plus. Motherfuckers know. The only reason that they got their views is because I made their channel. Without me, your channel was shit.
You ain't heard of me? Well, you probably are.
Ask about me.
Nice to meet you. So good to see you. Bros wanna act hard, they need to take it easy.
And that's why you guys continue to diss me. Because you guys, only way you know how to get recognition is to diss a guy like me. Because without my name in your mouth, you ain't going nowhere. And it's pretty pathetic that you have to stoop that low. I mean, I didn't start doing music, like I said, really until 2010. When I was at a Halloween party, I threw a Halloween mask on for a joke, and people loved it, and I had an idea. And I had an idea, and I ran with it. And when Krimzon runs with an idea, Cringe Gang, we don't stop. We are successful. And if we ain't successful, we don't stop until we're successful. We'll go to any measures. We'll go on every goddamn TV show in the fucking United States until we get famous. And we don't stop until we're to the fucking top. I'll be damned if a motherfucker thinks he knows me just from that show. Cause I do the wicked shit. Ain't nobody doing a show like mine. Now let me tell you my concept of my shows. Just because I sing the wicked shit, there's a fucking whole story behind this. I spit my style, my lyrics, my wicked shit, and there's a fucking stage show that goes with it. And people don't realize that. It's an entire show. It's a fucking show. You know, like kind of like how Alice Cooper does this shit. You hear that shit? No, I've been grinding hard since 2010. I live, sleep, shit promotion. I'm up almost all night, every night. I'm a full-time dad, I fucking work, and I promote. I promote at my desk at work. I promote, promote, promote. I stay promoting, and anybody who truly knows me would tell you that. Ain't nothing slacking in my game.
I just want to say that I don't care what anybody thinks. Krimzon is the shit. His music is fucking badass. And anybody who talks shit otherwise is fucking completely dumb. The man is a genius with his music, and obviously it shows. So anybody that hates are the ones that cannot reproduce what he does. Enjoy, my friends. Krimzon fan for life.
Hey, what's up, Cringe Gang? I'll be the first one to say, man, Krimzon X, your music, man, it's trash. It's trailer trash music. The vlogs are dope. The costumes are dope. Your man's doing his thing. There's nothing y'all can do. There's nothing y'all can say. You're gonna keep hating. You're gonna keep making the man rich. Got mad respect for you. I love the vlog. Music, not so much. Just keeping it real. But you know what they say. Opinions are like assholes. We all got one, you know?
Krimzon X, you're awesome, okay? Don't let any of those haters get in your way, man. You're awesome. I know a lot of people aren't liking you right now, but I think if you collab with Twisted, you do pretty awesome, dude. I have very good faith in you. Keep up your awesome music. My mom and dad doesn't like it, but I think it's not necessarily real, I know. And I think I've been wanting to feel stuff like that, people that have been picked on me for a while, but I would never do it. You're awesome. Keep it up.
I just want to apologize to Krimzon X for everything I've ever said. But I seen a clip of a rapper, Krimzon X. He went on Dr. Phil. Dr. Phil and the ICP made him look like trash. I went and researched everything I could about this guy until I watched one video from this guy. Just one. I was like, yo, you suck. Your bars are weak. Fuck you. You're a piece of shit. After I made the comment, 99% of it was bullshit. I researched this guy some more. You know, he's dropping some more stuff tomorrow, which I'm excited about. I can't wait, personally, as a fan. You know, because his music didn't suck, dude. I said that shit because I wanted to piss this motherfucker off. I wanted to get underneath his skin. He's a really good rapper. He's actually really pretty awesome. I like his stuff. He does murder rap. He does, like, music like ICP. The difference is he's 10 times better than ICP. I just want to give this dude a shout-out, and I'd like to apologize. Dude, don't ever give up on your dream. You're not a piece of shit. You're actually pretty fucking decent. I like your music. Just never stop, bro. Krimzon, I was wrong. I'm sorry. Krimzon, I want to give you a shout out again. I'm going to be showing much more love to you, by the way. I'm going to be tossing your name everywhere, bro. I hope to God to help you blow up. Krimzon Nation, bro. That's what I'm going for. The Krimzon Nation. With that being said, peace. I'm out.
Longest catch making a lot of noise, and he is just getting bigger and bigger and badder and better. Krimzon, welcome to Scare Radio.
Funny you say that, man. I was just going to say.
Whenever you're doing great things, my friend,
you get hate.
You're going to get hate. And all that is, and the way you have to look at it is, it's confirmation that you're doing something right.
Yep.
Because if you weren't doing nothing right, motherfuckers would have no reason to hate you.
You have to put in work to get fucking work. Just like with the Phil show, I got denied fucking 8 times before I finally got accepted, but I put in that work and I pushed until I fucking got on there. And now motherfuckers talk like it's all this and that. You know why? Because there's so much envy and jealousy in these artists' eyes. Because like I told you guys before, they don't want to know Krimzon X is making it. It'll eat them up to know that I'm fucking succeeding. That's how sick these people have become. But I can tell you, I'm the king of this wicked shit. And you know why I think like that? Because with a positive mind and the way I think, nothing can ever let me down. I won't accept failure. failure. Failure doesn't exist to me. I will succeed. Like I said, if it takes me till I'm 90 years old to make it to the very top, then that's what it's gonna take. But there ain't no getting rid of Krimzon X. Every artist has their own style. You gotta respect the game, respect the hustle. And if you don't respect the game and respect people's style, then you ain't got shit. Your word ain't shit. People look at you like, oh, he talks behind his back, he gonna talk behind my back. It's the same shit. And I realized a lot of motherfuckers that were claiming to be cool with me, like on all them interviews before the Dr. Phil and after, they just wanted that interview for them views. And if you notice, I made most of them motherfuckers' channels. And you know who I'm talking about. They don't know the lifestyle I live. They don't know the struggles I went through. They never have been through the shit I've been through. It's easy to talk on an internet where you're safe behind a screen. I started all this shit, this grinding, this music shit, since 13 years old. 12, end to 12, 13. End of Ringmaster era. Insane Clown Posse used to go to Godwin High School, bring their riddle box vans up there, hand out fucking samplers at the middle school, and that's how I got a whole backpack full of them. I was handing them out to all the stoners, all the kids. They didn't know what it was. Insane Clown Posse just hit the streets, and that's why on the Dr. Phil show, when I told Jay, I said, look, I've been following you since the Kalamazoo warehouse, and he knew what that meant.
I am living my dream, though. I am living my dream, and I supported Insane Clown Posse since when you guys were only maybe had 100 followers, since I was 13. I'm 37. I was going to Kalamazoo warehouse, front row at your guys' shows. I followed you my entire life.
I came before Juggalos even existed. Maybe 60, 70 to 100 people tops at an Insane Clown Posse show. I mean, I'd go all the way to Detroit, to the Palladium, to State Theater. There was a bunch of other low-budget fucking venues at the time I used to go see ICP at. I would go all the way to Detroit to go see them. Like, I started introducing Insane Clown Posse to people. What up?
Are you live feeding right now, dude?
There's my homie, Adam. That was my old manager that used to work at my tattoo shop when I had it from 2011 to 2013. Also, he was my manager from the start since 2010. So he would have been really good to have on this documentary that I'm shooting.